Here's the credits! So, yeah, that's Knuckles' story in a nutshell. I did it all in one day, just like I did with Tails. There's the casino area, and there is the mysterious area that has not yet been quite explained. There is an awesome Knuckles rap going on in the background here. I'll let you listen to that for a second. Anyway, there was Knuckles when he fell on Sonic and Tails being knocked out by the knockout gas, if you recall that portion of the story with Sonic and Tails. There's the exclusive area with Eggman. And the Chaos 2 battle, if you recall, there's when he gets trapped in the cage and finds that ridiculous monkey destruction switch. That is like the silliest thing I have ever seen in a game. Well, one of the most silly things. I mean, seriously, a switch that is designed to destroy any robotic monkeys in the nearby facility if you drop it and the switch gets pressed. Who builds a switch like that? That is just plain silly. I mean, seriously. Why would Eggman build such a... why would he build the monkeys and then build a monkey destruction switch for them to get blown off? And he hides it somewhere that he knows Knuckles could dig underground to get. Or maybe he didn't know Knuckles could dig underground to get it because Knuckles didn't have that particular power-up at the time. But the power-up was right in the tunnel that monkey destruction switch was buried in. You would think that he wouldn't miss it. I mean, it was glowing with a bluish green and with a slight hint of yellow light. I mean, what the poop was he thinking when he made that thing? Oh, well, it's good times anyway. Just watching pointing out the plot holes and the silliness that this game offers just for the sheer fun of it. As that is what I do as a game walkthrougher, as well as giving tips to you guys. And hopefully providing entertainment. However, my entertainment factor depends entirely on the viewer, of course. Some people might hate it, some people may like it, some people are neutral. What can you say? Everyone's different. And so there's Knuckles. I don't know what the heck he's doing there. It appears that he's looking at his shovel claws for some reason. I don't know why he's doing that. And there's a statue. Maybe he was looking at them because he was thinking how to use his shovel claws, even though prior to that they already showed the tutorial on how to use them by simply pressing both the A and B button at the same time. I have no idea. But I am rambling on as usual, because this is the credits, and there really isn't much to talk about in the credits, as I said before. But I do like the song that Knuckles has, I gotta say. I like all the themes, I gotta say, that the characters have. Someone posted in the comments that they actually made a soundtrack for this game, so this game had a wide enough soundtrack to make a wide enough music. I guess you could call the game soundtrack, that it had enough tracks to make a CD of it. And they basically did that to get more money off the game, you know, because people would buy the soundtrack if they bought the game, or it's just like something extra that Sega can get for the game. You get the idea. I don't know, I'm just rambling on aimlessly as I usually do. And created by Sonic Team. That is right. It is not created by me whatsoever. But I did do the walkthrough on it to teach you guys how to get through the game. Well, the first three stories so far, it is copyrighted by Sega. And, that about does it for Knuckles' story. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you when I start Amy's story. Toodaloo!